Thank you so much for staying with us. Thank you so much for staying with us. Yeah. We have on the inside with us ISUPK. Welcome, Gap Back Brothers. How are you doing today?
Shalom, Aisha. Shalom, I'm the callers, the viewers. It's been a while. And we thank Iowa George and everybody for the listeners. We thank everybody for listening to us and calling us for the time that we even wasn't here. Right? And also, too, thanks for David Muhammad for inviting us to the black market. Right? The black market was wonderful. We meet some people who actually remembered us on your show, Am I Showers.
Okay, very right? Nice. So, you have fans.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Yeah, man, I don't know. Just, again, thanks for everything, for all your support, and continue to follow up. And we're definitely looking forward to continue to connect with you all, man. You know what I mean? And good afternoon, of course, to your listeners.
Right. Excellent. So, what are you guys touching on today?
Well, we're touching on this. Well, the controversial topic, this plague that is taking over this earth right now. All right. So, start with the scripture first.
It's the book of Exodus, chapter 9, verse 13. And the Lord said unto Moses, "Rise up early in the morning, and stand before Pharaoh." All
right. So, go ahead.
And say unto him, "Thus saith the Lord God of the Hebrews, let my people go, that right. they may serve me."
Right, so the Lord wanted Pharaoh to let his people go so that they could serve him. Right, go ahead.
Verse 14. "For I will at this time send all my plagues upon thine heart, and upon thy servants, and upon thy people, that thou mayest know that there is none like me in all the earth."
Right, so God is actually, he's boasting in a way. If you don't let the Israelites and them go, today the Israelites is blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians. If you don't let them go, I will send plagues and pestilence
right.
upon you and your people. Mm-hmm. Right? And the most thing here what people have to understand is the Lord only cares about the Israelites who are black, Hispanic, and Native Indians. Mm-hmm. Right? So we alone does get punished. But in this term here, Pharaoh was harming the Lord's people. And on top of the Pharaoh harming the Lord's people, he did not want it to let the Lord's children go.
Right.
So the Lord had to send plagues at Pharaoh and let him know who is boss.
Right.
Pharaoh feel he's boss, where the Lord sending plagues and pestilence. Just like how the Lord sending plagues and pestilence right now on the face of the earth
right.
with this COVID-19. And read the last one. 15.
Verse 15. "For now I will stretch out my hand, that I may smite thee and thy people with pestilence, and thou shalt be cut off from the earth."
Right, so the Lord is actually telling this African, because the Pharaoh was African.
Right.
The Lord say, if you don't let the Israelites and them go, if you don't let the Venezuelans and them go, because the Venezuelans is Israelites.
Right.
If you don't let the Native Indians and them go, that means the first peoples in Arima.
Right.
If you don't let the people in John and Silots and Bitum go.
Right.
Pharaoh, he is going to send plagues and diseases upon you and your people. And that is what the Lord doing right now. The Lord is doing a drive-by, and right. he's letting go his plagues. All kind of different strands is seen from this COVID-19. Right? The latest strand now is the Omicron. That's the latest strand. And on top of that, it's going to have more strands coming out. It's going to be worse. Mm-hmm. When you read Deuteronomy 28 chapter, the Lord told the Israelites, he's going to send plagues that we never even heard about.
Right.
Right, and that is what's going on right now in the earth. And there's only one way to really stop all of this. No, you're giving me the next one, right?
Definitely.
1 Samuel 2 and 6. Right, there's only one way to stop all of this right now. It's to come back to the Lord's laws of the Bible. That is the only way to stop all of this. All kind of conspiracies you're hearing on the Facebook,
mm-hmm.
all kind of conspiracies you're hearing.
Mm-hmm.
Don't believe in those conspiracies. In the Bible, the Lord said to honor your physician. Your physician is your doctor.
That's right.
Imagine the CMO. He went UE and went all kind of university to study doctoring. And somebody who don't know nothing about doctor, or what might know them, maybe working some high law KSC or working some way that they have nothing to do with being a doctor.
Right.
They coming on all kind of social media platform and telling you, don't take the job. You understand? But the CMO who went and studied telling you, no, this could save your life.
Right.
Or this could at least decrease your chances.
Right.
You have a better fighting chance
right.
if you take it.
Right.
Nobody don't want to listen to the man who studied. Mm-hmm. People want to listen to people who never study mm-hmm. nothing about a doctor.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So give me the scripture.
The book of 1 Samuel chapter 2 and verse 6. The Lord killeth and maketh alive.
The Lord killeth and maketh alive.
Mm-hmm.
Right. I have, I was in a slave the other day with a worker, and he telling me his good close friend took the job and died. I say, here, what's going on? If you do a research, mm-hmm. right, because you say his friend took the job and get a blood clot and died.
Right.
I say, I did a research, and when you look it up, they say 4 people out of 1 million people mm-hmm. does get blood clots
right.
if they take it. 4. Mm-hmm. That is something very rare.
Mm-hmm.
So you know what I told him? I said, if somebody get blood clots and die, from taking the job, well, guess what? Is the Lord wanted them to die?
Right.
4 people out of a million.
Mm-hmm.
That's very rare and hard.
Right.
Don't blame the job. Mm-hmm. Is take it up with the Lord. The Lord just wanted them to die. Read over the scripture again, Tazo.
Come on. First Samuel chapter 2, verse 6. The Lord kill it and make it alive.
The Lord kill it and make it alive. He's the man right now. Is the Lord right now? Is killing people right now.
Mm-hmm.
Don't blame nothing. Don't believe in no conspiracy. Don't believe in what those Christians saying that the mark of the beast is the job. That is, the job is not the mark of the beast. You know what is the mark of the beast? Mm-hmm. Christianity is the mark of the beast.
That's right.
Because Christians kill more people than this COVID-19.
That's right.
Christians kill more. Ask any drug dealer. Mm-hmm. Ask any murderer.
Mm-hmm.
What religion they believe in. They're going to say they're a Christian. They know the Bible. They just read the Bible.
Mm-hmm.
Just ask them.
Mm-hmm.
Christians kill more people than this COVID-19.
Right.
In 1920, when the Spanish flu came out,
mm-hmm.
50 million people died because they didn't have a job.
Right.
They didn't create one.
Right.
They took years to invent it, so 50 million people died.
Mm-hmm.
Now, because they invent a job quick,
mm-hmm.
only 5 million, over 5 million people die worldwide.
Mm-hmm.
And y'all still want to believe in these conspiracies?
Mm-hmm.
But just take it up with the Lord. Is right. The Lord is what killing all of these people? The Lord say, honor a physician. If your physician say, take it, then take it.
Mm-hmm.
If your physician say, don't take it,
mm-hmm.
then don't take it.
Right.
But don't go on social media and be frightening people
mm-hmm.
to not take the jab
mm-hmm.
that could make them get a better fighting chance.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So give me the third scripture I'm talking about. Matthew 16 and 28.
Definitely. Book of Matthew chapter 16 and verse 28. Verily I say unto you, there be some standing here which shall not taste of death till they see the Son of Man coming in his kingdom.
Mm-hmm. So as I said before, Christians kill more people than this COVID-19.
Right.
So Christianity is the mark of the beast.
Mm-hmm.
The job never rape and molest nobody in church.
Right.
It's the pastor that's been raping little boys and little girls in the church.
Right.
So, if you have to run from something or be frightened from something, then be frightened from a Christian pastor.
Right.
Don't be frightened at the job. Mm-hmm. I'd rather take the job and run away from church.
Right.
Because if I send my little son in church, 98% of the chances, he will get raped by the pastor.
That's right.
Right? But guess what? Christ said, here, what's going on? All of who frightened at this COVID-19 what we're passing, you know? Christ said, when I return, all in one. All ain't taste death yet until Christ returns. The Son of Man is Christ.
Mm-hmm.
That is the Son of Man.
Mm-hmm.
Christ said when he returns, then all are going to taste death. All are feeling bad now.
Mm-hmm.
When Christ returns, it's going to be worse.
Mm-hmm.
And I know some people that say that he ain't Christ go come donkey years ago. Well, all are better be thankful that Christ ain't return yet. Christ is giving all a grace period for all to change all your life.
Mm-hmm.
That's what Christ is doing right now. You understand? When you ain't pay a light bill, they won't cut you one time. They go call you. They will give you a grace period to pay a light bill.
Right.
Christ is giving us a grace period right now for us to change our life.
Mm-hmm.
Because when he come back, that is when all are going and taste death. If all are feel all are have it bad now, from this COVID-19 and different strands coming out, when Christ returns, is going to be worse. And the only way to stop all of this is for us to fix our life and change our life. Let me be born again.
Mm-hmm.
How just be born again? By getting baptized. How just be baptized? By obeying the laws of the Bible.
That's right.
Baptism is learning the laws of the Bible.
Mm-hmm.
That is baptism. And I just want to say, we're not affiliated with no religious organization we're not affiliated with GMS, GOCC, IUIC, no Catholic Church. We're not affiliated with none of them.
Right.
The only people who have the authority to teach the Bible is the men in the ISGPK.
That's right.
Nobody else has the authority to teach this Bible. Nobody else.
Right.
Everybody else, once you go and listen to them, you'll be confused. And when the true prophets actually come and explain to you, you're going to be like, what did I say? The white man invented that. Don't take that. But come on, man. If the white man wanted to kill us,
he
would have paid to the KFC.
Right. Yeah.
Because the majority of people eating the food from the white man is black people. He would have done paid to the KFC and he would have done dead already. Why would he want to create a medicine? What he himself taking to kill us? It don't make no sense.
Right.
It's just a conspiracy and a rumor. Right.
And if I may add to exactly what you're saying there, nobody kicking up that about 500,000 of all people dying in Planned Parenthood. Nobody kicking up our brass for that, and you know who's supporting it? The Christian Church.
The Catholic Church
and all that, they're encouraging that madness. That is genocide. That is a way, strategically, that is a conspiracy right there.
Yeah.
Nobody making a fuss about it. Yes, sir, go ahead.
Yeah. Give me the one in Matthew 23 and 15.
The book of Matthew chapter 23 and verse 15. Woe unto you, scribes and Pharisees, hypocrites, for ye compass sea and land.
The 23 and 15?
Good.
Mm-hmm.
For ye compass sea and land to make one proselyte. And when he is made, ye make him twofold more the child of hell than yourself.
Right, to make one proselyte. A proselyte is a student. So what Christ is saying here is hypocrites. Christ is calling the religious leaders hypocrites.
Right.
The Pharisees and Sadducees, they are hypocrites.
That's right.
Why Christ was calling them hypocrites? Because they're saying something and they're not doing it.
That's it.
Right? They're speaking in lies. That's why Christ was calling them hypocrites. Christ didn't say the Seventh-day Adventists is hypocrites.
Right.
Christ brand all of them as hypocrites.
Right.
That is what he did. Right? And a proselyte is a student. So what Christ is saying here now, this religious leader going and teach a student to be
two times the child of hell.
Two times the child of hell. In other words, he going to teach the student to be worse, more worse than him. That's what the Bible is trying to say. Two times as worse as hell.
Right.
Hell is a condition on earth. Not a place underground with fire that's burning. That's why you see people just commit suicide. Remember, everybody's Christians. Christianity in the airways. Anyway, you walk, you hear some pastor talking. You put on the radio, you turn on the TV, some pastor talking.
Right.
Everybody's a Christian. So everybody knows or believe, right, which is not true, that hell is a place underground with fire that's burning. So if hell is a place underground with fire that's burning, why is people still committing suicide knowing that they will go underground and be burnt in fire? It's because, you know why? Because the condition that we live in right here on earth is worse than getting burned in fire.
Yeah.
Right? That myth about hell is a place underground where fire does burn you, that is a myth. That comes from a poem called Dante's Inferno. Right? And the Catholic Church at that time love the idea of heaven and hell that comes from the poem Dante's Inferno. And he run it through the whole church till it spread like wildfire.
Right.
That hell is this place underground fire that's burning. Hell is just a bad condition.
Right.
Black people living in hell right now. Right? We getting kicked out of our house here.
To add to what you're saying there, exactly, because for our forefathers them to know that this is what the same Catholic Church and them was pushing on us. And they say, I'd rather take the stake and die burning. You understand that from a training to probably face molestation every day. And that kind of way, because they believe, and next doctrine again, they're pushing, they're giving them license now to put fear in people so that they will take molestation and stay quiet. You know what I mean? And then if you misbehave, or if you're telling me, you're going underground and fire.
Yeah, that is itself. You understand? Imagine people getting raped and molested. People. Some children born with AIDS, diabetes, cancer. That is hell. Hell is a bad condition. Shadow was not in the truth. He was not in the ISGPK, but Shadow, he knows hell. Poverty is hell.
Right.
You go into the ghettos and you see how black people living in poverty. That is hell. Once somebody actually come in here and actually see how black people living, they go say, all right, I understand why it is you're smoking. Now, smoking wrong, but I understand why it is he's smoking. Because this what he going through here, living with cockroach and rats, and all kind of manicure running through the house, and for the whole week is only rice and butter he mixing up to eat. I understand now why it is he's smoking. I understand now why it is he doing certain things to ease his stress. Yes, it is wrong, because smoking is wrong.
Right.
But you gotta understand why they do it. Hell is a condition on earth. And black people, you in hell right now.
Mm-hmm. You understand? Give me the next scripture there.
Galatians?
Yeah.
The book of Galatians chapter 4 and verse 16. Am I therefore become your enemy because I tell you the truth?
Right. Have I become your enemy because I am told you the truth? Right. There's a lot of people here who they go say, nah, what I'm saying here don't make sense. You understand? They go hate us. They want to call us all kind of names, but it is the truth.
That's it.
You understand? Yes, your family member maybe died, they get blood clots, you know, because they took the jab or whatever. But don't blame the jab. Don't come on social media and blame the jab. Take it up with the Lord. You had to pray and say, Lord, I understand now why it is you took my family and member's life because they take the jab. You want me to change my ways. You want me to stop being an adulterer and adulteress. You understand? You turn on the news, there's all kind of love triangle going wrong and this one kidnapped this one because, you know, let me tell you something. A man could have more than one wife. Yes, that is true. But the woman have to be single. She cannot have no other man.
That's it.
If she has some other man, that is a love triangle. That is bacchanal and confusion right there.
Right.
So the Lord wants you to change your ways and live. And guess what? If you don't die from the COVID-19, if the Lord don't send me plague and die from the COVID-19, just because of your sinful ways, the Lord going to make you die from something else.
That's it.
Example, a love triangle gone bad. The police officer and the coast guard shoot themselves. We shoot each other. Right? So, anything to say?
Can't say for me, because you're talking about, you know, lifestyle, this and lifestyle, that, and I want to live my life on all of them different ways. The pastor and them same people in them is the ones that causing you. You follow the rule on your way to living, or as the scripture saying here, to be a student twice as evil as he is. Because he's not telling you, according to the laws of the Lord, that made to protect you, you're not supposed to be eating this and that the other. That is why you have what you call lifestyle diseases.
Mm-hmm.
All of these different contributing factors is why people dying faster. Among your adultery, you understand? Among your smoking habits and all them different things, and because they never put it to you that, hey, this system is supposed to live by. They're not teaching you that. You follow that, what they see in the laws, that the laws done away with. And have you living how you want to feel and how you think you should live and all that, when the guidelines right here. But because they're not about that, they can never show you exactly how to live. That's why, you understand, the men in the ICPK is the only men you follow that certify and can actually do this, because you had to live the standard. You follow this, what you had to do. There's nothing else to do. You follow everywhere else, you're just going down the pathway. Soon to death, you might find, you know, it might feel nice right now. You know, the ride could be smooth until you understand you bounce up something that you can't take your head out of. You want to know how you reach there. Your lifestyle. Lifestyle is it the same way you're eating, the same lifestyle you're living? It's that you go up. That is just what it is. And you had to tell you the truth.
Right. And if I just touch on that, the COVID-19 started from a lifestyle eating, right? God said, don't eat no bats.
Right.
Them in China want to eat bats. Mm-hmm. Well, they eat bats,
right.
COVID-19 appear.
Mm-hmm.
And different strands are starting to come out.
Right.
You understand? They say hepatitis A.
Mm-hmm.
You could get it from eating shellfish.
Mm-hmm.
Right? There's different things. They say AIDS starting from monkey. Mm-hmm. Right? Well, you go have the conspiracy theory saying, no, some man created it. Well, okay, whether a man created it or whether it come from a monkey, the Lord wanted that plague and disease to come on the face of it.
That's it.
To teach us a lesson.
Right.
Yeah, so I just saw an article the other day showing a gynecologist was telling the men that they will get throat cancer from having too much oral, right, on the women. So you're warning them.
Mm-hmm.
So, fellas, stay with your wives. Okay. If you have three wives, once they're single, I ain't saying if she have a neck, you have to leave the woman. If she have a man, you have to leave she.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Right? But if she's single, stay with your wives. Mm-hmm. But don't go outside to have a loud triangle to make you go on sour again. Mm-hmm. You understand? And don't blame this COVID-19 that killing people. Mm-hmm. And don't blame the jab. If you say your family there could take the jab, okay. Mm-hmm. Don't blame the jab. Mm-hmm. Right? I would tell people, go and take it. Because mm-hmm. you will have a better fighting chance if you take it. If you look at the statistics again, the CMO, mm-hmm. show that mm-hmm. the people who took the jab is a few of them that mm-hmm. died compared to who intake is. It's so big. Mm-hmm. So why are we listening to people who is not doctors and mm-hmm. believing what they're saying? Mm-hmm. Stop believing the conspiracy theories. Mm-hmm. Right? And again, I must pong this hard in. Right. People who saying the jab is the mark of the beast. That mm-hmm. is not the mark of the beast. Christianity is the mark of the beast. Mm-hmm. Right? Christians does rape and molest people. The jab don't do that. Mm-hmm. So I would run from a Christian pastor. I wouldn't run from the jab. Mm-hmm. Right? Just this sister monk Saint Benedict make a video actually mm-hmm. saying the pastor rape she in church. Mm-hmm. And up to now we ain't hear nothing about it. No police investigate. Nobody investigate. It's like everybody just allowing the Christian leaders to just mm-hmm. do what they're doing. Yeah, all continue to rape and molest people. All go ahead. You are grant money. Go ahead, take the grant money now. You continue to rape and molest people in church. Come on, man. We have to steer away from the church. Mm-hmm. Run away from all those people and them from the church. Mm-hmm. And the only people to have the authority from the Lord to teach this Bible mm-hmm. is the men in this ISUBK.
That's right.
And commanding General Hannah, he's the man in charge of this nation. He's the man we had to be following right now, commanding General Hannah. Mm-hmm. Don't listen to GMS. Mm-hmm. Don't listen to GOCC. Mm-hmm. Don't listen to IUIC. Mm-hmm. Don't listen to no Christian leaders. Mm-hmm. Don't listen to nobody else but us.
Right.
A strong leader mm-hmm. is in the ISUPK. A strong leader mm-hmm. is in the ISUPK, and that is commanding General Hannah. Right? And just want to say before I forget, don't forget Black Watch is tonight at 10 o'clock because mm-hmm.
right.
the time changed. So it's 10 o'clock tonight. Black Watch, come on, listen to Commander General Hannah and all the generals and the captains. Mm-hmm. They're going to break it down. They're going to talk about anything. If you want to come in and ask questions, you ask the questions. Mm-hmm. Right? If all want to contact me, all the Venezuelans, right? If all want to contact us, all the people in John Silat's library, mm-hmm. all the people in the Congo, Bitum, the number to dial is 290-5173. If anybody in the prison mm-hmm. want to call us and contact us, 290-5173.
That's right.
Right, anything is it?
Definitely. And if mm-hmm. you want a fighting chance, obey the Lord. Above all, you understand how you learn that is coming into class. Feel free, you know, give it the number there. Call the number 290-5173. ICBK on Facebook and YouTube. Reach out. We want to answer your questions and we want to let the Lord spare your life. We don't want to see our people continue to die, understand, and unnecessarily and being back and out one another and all kind of different things. We don't need to add it. If follow nature itself showing you follow your plant good seed, you get good harvest. So what kind of seed you want to plant? Is what kind of life you want to live? Decide now. Before mm-hmm. it's too late. Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. Is it? Anybody?
Mm-hmm. Let's see who's on the line. Caller, you live?
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Brother, I think you are the mark of the beast. You're a total mess.
Thank you so much. Mm-hmm. You want to respond? Or?
Well, again, as I said, Galatians 4 and 16, mm-hmm. have I become your enemy because I spoke the truth? Mm-hmm. Right? Once people hear the truth, they'll get offended. Mm-hmm. Right? Because again, we have the medicine to heal earlier. Mm-hmm. But a lot of people doesn't like to go to the doctor to get healed mm-hmm. because some of the medicine is so bitter and it tastes mm-hmm. gruesome, but it'll save your life. Some people just don't want to hear it, and this sister is one of them. But I pray to the Lord that she, you know, she get the understanding and she understand what we say,
right.
and she walks away from that Christian church.
That's it.
Mm-hmm.
All right, closing comments as we get ready to wrap things up.
All right, closing comments again. We have classes, right? Saturdays, Sundays. Mm-hmm. If all want to contact me on 290-5173. That is the school's number. Mm-hmm. All right, Black Watches tonight, Commanding General Hannah. He's the leader of the nation. Right, Allah, come and get that medicine. The medicine might not taste good for you, but it's there to heal you. It's going to cure you.
That's right.
You're going and get saved.
Damn right.
Right?
So, you think? So, no, is it?
All right, guys. Thank you so much for staying.